Hello, I'm Simon Whistler, you're watching Top 10's Net, and in the video today we're looking at the top 10 out of this world, literally, facts about space. Number 10. Water pools in space.
In 2011, astronomers discovered a gigantic vapor cloud caught in the gravitational pull of a black hole deep within the universe, making it the largest discovery of water anywhere. According to Universe Today, the cloud, known as a reservoir in astronomical circles, is believed to be capable of holding all of the Earth's oceans, 140 trillion times over. While the discovery of water in space is not headline news, it is the sheer volume of water discovered and the fact that the reservoir seems to be slightly younger than the Big Bang itself that has caught the attention of scientists. Matt Bradford from NASA has stated that the discovery is another demonstration that water is pervasive throughout the universe, even at the very earliest times. So if the Earth ever runs out of water, at least we know where we can go to find ourselves an intergalactic water pump. The only problem is how to get there, because it currently resides about 10 billion light years from Earth.
Number 9. It would take 225 million years to walk a light year.
Don't believe me? Well, as all great mathematicians suggest, let us show our workings. First, one light year, the distance light travels in a year, is about 5.9 trillion miles. If you briskly walked 5.9 trillion miles at 20 minutes per mile constantly without any breaks, you would complete your light year stroll in 225 million years. In other words, if you started your walk just before the emergence of the dinosaurs, you would be about to finish now. On an interesting side note, according to Jessica Cheng in the September 2008 edition of Popular Science magazine, the long trip would come with a unique set of problems. She estimates that in order to complete the journey, you would need about 1.8 billion pairs of shoes. Not to mention that you would be burning about 80 calories per mile and would therefore need an average of 2 trillion power bars to fuel your body for the trip. Cheng also goes on to suggest that after such a journey, you wouldn't have got very far. In an astronomical sense, one light year is about the equivalent of you just reaching the end of Earth's garden path. The nearest star from Earth, Proxima Centauri, is a staggering 4.22 light years away.
Number 8. Eros, asteroid of riches.
In 1998, the near-Earth asteroid Rendezvous spacecraft passed close to the asteroid Eros and relayed back to Earth its findings. It discovered that Eros was a floating treasure chest of unprecedented riches. Due to its size, NASA has suggested that if Eros consists of 3% metal, like so many meteorites that fall to Earth, then it's not beyond the realms of possibility that Eros might contain 1.8 billion metric tons of gold and other precious metals such as platinum. According to Dr. David Whitehouse, then science editor for the BBC, in an article entitled Gold Rush in Space, Eros is indeed a large, but by no means the largest, of asteroids. That being said, he believes that since Eros is speculated to contain a multitude of rare elements, the asteroid has a total monetary worth of close to $20,000 billion. Of course, it goes without saying that if Eros ever impacted Earth, its priceless metal content and indeed monetary value will be of little consolation for what would most certainly be an extinct mankind.
Number 7. There are 1,397 known asteroids that could end mankind.
In an attempt to prevent the dramatic scenes of movies such as Armageddon, NASA has its eyes fixed on the 1,397 asteroids in and around our solar system that could, upon impact with Earth, bring about the end of the human race. You can rest assured that should anything larger than 350 feet in diameter come within 4.6 million miles of the Earth, NASA will be on critical alert. The extent to which NASA is aware of potentially hazardous asteroids, PHAs, is both impressive and frightening. Rather ominously, NASA has released an orbit plan for each of the 1,397 known PHAs. Aside from looking like somebody's overzealous attempt at getting to grips with a spirograph, the images do not fail to impress the severity of PHAs and the real and continual threat that they pose to mankind. As Dan Nosowitz suggests in the August 5, 2013 edition of Popular Science magazine, it is hard to believe that we have yet to be impacted by one of these Destruction Max asteroids.
Number 6. The International Space Station travels at 5 miles a second.
According to Cool Cosmos, a NASA education and outreach website, the International Space Station orbits the Earth at a speed of roughly 17,150 miles per hour. This equates to the station traveling 5 miles every second, with its crew witnessing a sunrise every 92 minutes.
Number 5. There are more stars than words spoken.
According to Scientific American, there are more stars in the universe than words that have been spoken by every human being who has ever lived. As much as this sounds like a gross exaggeration of fact, the true number of stars in the universe is probably a number so vast that it is beyond the comprehension of the human brain. For example, Nicola Willett of the Mars Society estimates that there are at least 70 sextillion times 10 to the power of 22 stars in the universe. She goes on to suggest that the universe itself probably contains more than 100 billion galaxies, each likely to contain billions of stars. Don't worry if this confuses you, as these are the sorts of numbers that we will never truly begin to understand. Our only certainty in the process of comprehending the total amount of stars in the universe is that we are likely to never know the true answer, as star counting is a process of hypothesizing with a large, and a very large at that, margin of error. In other words, nobody has known, knows presently, and will likely never know the true figure of the sum of all the stars in the universe.
Number 4. The moon suffers from moonquakes.
When Clive R. Neal, Associate Professor of Civil Engineering and Geological Sciences at the University of Notre Dame, and a team of 15 planetary scientists re-examined Apollo data from the 1970s, he concluded that the moon is seismically active. Seismometers placed at the landing sites of the Apollo missions between 1969 and 1972 radioed data back to Earth until they were taken offline in 1977. The results were surprising, suggesting that there are at least four types of moonquakes. 1. Deep moonquakes that occur on average around 700 kilometers below the moon's surface and are probably triggered by Earth's tidal forces. 2. Usual vibrations and minor moonquakes as a result of meteorite impact. 3. Thermal moonquakes caused by the sun when illuminating and expanding the frigid crust on the moon's surface following a 2-week deep freeze lunar night. 4. Shallow moonquakes that occur frequently at a depth of 20 to 30 kilometers below the moon's surface. In truth, nobody is really certain what exactly causes moonquakes. Speculation is rife among scientists. All that is known is that unlike earthquakes, moonquakes last longer. This is because, unlike the Earth, the moon's crust is hard and uncompressible. Therefore, a moonquake tends to vibrate the moon like a tuning fork, whereas the Earth has elements of compression, like water and minerals, that act like a sponge during an earthquake and disperse the tremors within a matter of minutes. On the moon, a moonquake has been known to last 10 minutes.
Number 3. Planet HD 189733b.
The Hubble telescope has identified a deep azure-blue planet in distant space. The planet, called HD 189733b, is a huge gas giant orbiting very close to its star. Its atmosphere is a hellish environment of 4,000 mph, 7,000 km/h winds, and molten glass that rains sideways. The estimated temperature of this deep blue space beast is a scorching 1,000 degrees Celsius. The planet might outwardly look serene and Earth-like, but its bluish hue is a result of silicate particles scattering blue light rather than any reflection of a serene tropical ocean. If mankind were ever to find itself in a situation similar to the movie Interstellar, this planet would be one of the most hostile environments in the known universe. Not that we would be able to reach it, as it is currently 63 light-years from Earth.
Number 2. The Earth has more than one moon.
If you thought the Earth only has one moon, it might surprise you to discover that this is actually false. While the moon is indeed the only celestial body to observe a strict orbit of the Earth, there are in fact a number of other near-Earth asteroids which follow the Earth as it orbits the Sun. These are called co-orbitals, and there are at least 6 known co-orbitals caught in the Earth's gravitational pull. However, don't think you can gaze into the night sky to find them, as most can't be seen with the naked eye. Of course, you might agree with many astronomers and suggest that these co-orbitals are not technically moons. However, what is clear is that while they may not be moons in the traditional sense, they are far from your average asteroid. Like the Earth, they orbit the Sun in roughly a year and occasionally pass close enough to the Earth to exert a slight gravitational influence. In astronomy terms, this means that the suggestion that they are in fact moons is all the more realistic. Robert DeGeek, an astronomer at the University of Hawaii, has suggested that at any time there are one or two 1-meter diameter asteroids in orbit around the Earth. Perhaps when we think of the Moon, we should consider the possibility that rather than the Earth having one solitary moon in Luna, the Earth has in fact a number of fluctuating moons that come and go throughout the year.
Number 1. There are less than 9 planets in our solar system.
Despite what you were taught in your science lessons, our solar system has less than 9 planets. Don't be fooled, you would be right in thinking that there were 9 planets 10 years ago, but in recent years, the International Astronomical Union has decided it would be a good idea to apply its own criteria of what constitutes a planet to our own solar system. The criteria stipulate that in order for something to be defined as a planet, it must 1. Orbit the Sun, 2. Have enough mass to be round in shape but doesn't have to be perfectly spherical, and 3. Have cleared their neighborhood or immediate orbit. The first planet to fall under the criteria was Pluto in 2006, when it was demoted from a planet to a dwarf planet. This is perhaps not surprising, as there has been much debate since Pluto's discovery about whether it is actually a planet. For years, it was seen as an icy rock, not too dissimilar to an oversized asteroid confined to the region of space at the very edge of the solar system. That makes 8 planets.
So I really hope you found that video about space interesting. If you did, why not check out some of our other space lists over there on the right? One is the top 10 theories on alien life, and below that we've got the top 10 ways that humans could colonize space. Also, if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and thank you for watching.